Hi folks, I'm Rob Paromas. I'm an oncologist, but I'm also Dean of the Long School of Medicine here at UT Health San Antonio. And I'm here today to interview Sylvia Boutros about interviewing virtually for residency and fellowship. Sylvia, tell us a little bit about yourself.
So I'm a female pelvic medicine and reconstructive surgery fellowship director and have been for quite a few years. And I'm here to represent our GME office and to give you some tips on how to interview.
Interviewing virtually is very different than interviewing in person, and it's a skill that most medical students don't have, and so we're here to help you gain that skill. And so we're going to spend 8 to 10 minutes talking about some tips on how to interview virtually, all as part of your growth as medical students, and we hope you find this useful. Sylvia, the first question is, what are a couple of tips for virtual interviews?
So I have three.
All right.
First, I would say, be yourself. Don't forget to be personable and as professional as you would be in person. The second thing I would say is be prepared. Think about the technology that you're going to use, what platform, download it, make sure that your internet is stable and working ahead of time. Think about the physical space. We look for clean, quiet, well-lit. Make sure you're not backlit. Free from distractions and minimal interruptions. And try to have a dry run if you can to try to work out the kinks. I wouldn't wing it on the day of the interview.
Great points. The last thing you want is your Labrador retriever jumping into your lap during your interview for your neurosurgery residency.
Right. And my third point would be just be gracious. There are bound to be technical challenges or challenges as a whole. And so try to be as gracious as you can.
Wonderful. I have a couple of other things I often suggest. Dress nice, but not too nice. Don't wear the tuxedo or the formal gown, but you want to look nice. You want to present nicely. Use your hands and be alive, because the camera often deadens you. So, but don't fidget. While someone else is talking to you, don't be using your hands. Use your hands for your answer, to illustrate your answer. And when you use your hands, don't go out towards the camera. I once had media training. They told me it looked like I was choking the cameraman when I reached out towards the camera. Smile, but don't guffaw, and look at the camera. Be personal. Let them see your eyes. So I like your personal and professional. A second question would be, what would be some of the worst mistakes you can make during a virtual interview?
So I would say virtual or in person, don't be rude, dishonest, or disinterested. Remember, the interview process starts from your first interaction. If you're rude to the program coordinator or anyone that you interact with, those things carry forward. And I would caution you to wear your pants or skirts or whatever it is you're wearing for the day, because for some reason, if you stand up and you happen to be wearing your pajama pants, it's not going to reflect well on you.
True. Great points. Don't be bored or robotic. Some people freeze in front of the camera or in front of their computer screen, or they look at themselves the whole time down the corner. That's also a telling point that they're more interested in what they look like than interacting with the interviewer. And if you do freeze, if you do get nervous, it's okay. Take a deep breath, gather yourself, think about the question, take 5 seconds, and then answer the question. If you really count to 5 or 10, that's plenty of time for you to think of an answer. And so don't be over anxious just because you're in front of a camera. Another question would be, how are virtual interviews different than in-person interviews?
So one of the things I would say is there's a lot of anxiety that comes with interviewing in general, and that seems to be heightened with this virtual process because of all of the uncertainty with this new format that we have and the new technology. So understand that that's going to come, and that's okay, and work through that. When it's all settled, I would say the one-on-one interaction that you have with your interviewer isn't that different from being in the room. I would caution you, though, to really think about making eye contact, and some of your, which means looking at the camera, but don't look at the camera so much that you're not able to read the body language of your interviewer. So there's got to be kind of this balance between looking at the camera to make eye contact, but also reading the person that's interviewing you. And then I would say The other major difference that I think is in the personal interactions of the day that we're just not able to replicate with the virtual process. So getting to know the residents kind of in that informal setting or those social settings, or getting to know your peers on the trail. But some of that could be mitigated by some of the social virtual interactions. So I would encourage you, if the program is offering those, to participate.
Right. The chat function is really important. And emojis and whatever you can do to virtually interact, I think, is really important besides just the one-on-one talking. Virtual interviews are more agenda-driven. That is, they're more defined in time, and the questions are all going to be standardized. And so memorizing answers to common questions will be really important. We'll talk about that in just a minute. But I think that you want to answer the questions with as much personal detail as possible so that they can get to know you, but not talk over long or too short. I think that 1 or 2 minute answers to most questions would be appropriate. You want to give enough detail so the interviewer feels like they can evaluate you. And the interviewer is on your side. They want you to do well. They don't want you to fail. They want you to have the best evaluation possible. So be thinking that they're able to see the best in you. And so even if you get nervous, that's very understandable. Just allow your thoughts together, return to the question, and proceed. Second to last question would be, what can someone do to stand out?
So I think there's two things here that I would recommend. I would say be prepared. I'm always impressed when the candidate has really shown that they've researched the program and the faculty.
Good point.
That shows their interest. And the second, I would say, be passionate. Be ready to share your own experiences, your accomplishments, and even the lessons that you've learned as you've gone through.
Great points. I always like to tell students to have a unique niche. I did this one special thing during medical school, and I really enjoyed it. For example, I volunteered at the refugee clinic in downtown San Antonio. Mm-hmm. Have something different about yourself. And this is, but not just say that, but say, this is what I learned during that experience. This is what the types of diseases I took care of. This was a mentor that really impressed me for his or her kindness or caring. And so tell a brief personal story about that unique niche. And then I think it's really important to try to connect with the school, wherever you're trying to go, or the hospital where you're trying to go. So you mentioned knowing a few things about the place you hope to become part of the team with. The more specific and detailed and personal that is, I took part in a refugee clinic, and you folks have a large inner city minority population, so I would feel right at home with that. So that allows the interviewer to see how you as a puzzle piece would fit within their puzzle and snap you into place. And it's all about fit. They choose residents certainly based on grades and scores, but also based on fit. How do you fit with our team? And so if you have some personal expertise or niche that fits with that program, be sure and communicate that. The last question, Sylvia, is what are common questions that you might encounter in a virtual interview?
So I think people are going to want to know why you're interested in that field, why that particular location. One of my favorites is kind of what challenges have you overcome and what have you learned from it? That's really a key part of that question.
I enjoy that question too. What is the hardest barrier you've had to overcome in your life and why? I always like to ask, what would their ultimate career goal be and what could they achieve that would make their career feel like a success? Because that gives insight into what drives them. We talked about what attracts them to our institution. I always ask, what are your strengths and weaknesses as a physician? And the real key part of that question is, what are your weaknesses? How good are you at self-assessing? And then I also ask, what do you think the most important characteristic of a physician is and why? And there's no right answer to that, but the why is very important. And then I ask, what past experiences have trained you most for this discipline? And then I also ask, how would you handle conflict with a colleague or a patient? Those are common questions that you'll see in many virtual interviews, which will be far more standardized. So take a couple of those questions that you feel you might be asked and memorize answers to those, but not such that you would become a robot. Make them your own words. Sylvia, any other thoughts about common questions?
No, I think you covered a good list. I think the key is that you're having a conversation with the person that you're interviewing. And so a lot of the points that you were speaking to, I think, relate to that. Like, try not to be robotic and try to be yourself and let your personality and character shine through.
Right. This is not a newscast. This is not a daily soap opera filming.
No.
This is a living room conversation, much like we are here,
yeah.
Having a conversation about how to interview virtually for residency or fellowship. And everyone is new at it, so you will be the same as everyone else.
Yeah.
And it will be a level playing field. But we're here to help, and we hope you find this helpful. With that, I'll say thank you very much for your attention, and may you find the best residency or fellowship position that fits you. Thank you very much.